Well, the controls really started from a simple idea. I had about 35 years at the National Security Agency, all of it in security testing for defense. So things like red teams or penetration testing, blue teams, which is cooperative testing, and the testing of products and cryptographic algorithms. And so I had the chance to see a lot of things fail. You know, how do bad guys attack? How do we attack when we pretend to attack ourselves? And one thing struck me over and over again was how often we just kept seeing the same things. The same attacks always worked. And it started to really bother me. You know, it's sort of easy work to attack systems over and over again, but it's not very satisfying because it doesn't really lead to improvements. So I started to realize something basic is going on here, and we need to figure out what it is. And what really struck me also was that defenders, it wasn't that defenders were lazy or they didn't care or they didn't have good tools or training. It's more that they were overwhelmed rather than empowered. There were just too many choices, too many demands. The business was changing really fast, so the demands on information technology were increasing all the time. Too many new products in the marketplace. So it wasn't the case of we didn't have good resources, it was that we had too many, and so it was overwhelming. So I gathered five friends in a room and gave them this challenge. What should all of our friends do to get started on security? Not to solve the entire problem, but to get started. Because that was the most frequent question I was getting when I was talking in public. So I would talk about security guidance and good configurations and all these things that we know we should do. And people would then say, yeah, but what do I do first? Where do I spend my first dollar? What do I ask the boss for support first? And I hadn't thought of it with that kind of clarity before. So I gathered those friends together and I said, okay, how should all of our friends get started? People that we care about, networks that we think are really important. Don't try to solve the problem. Don't try to solve world hunger, because that's the nature of security people, right? You ask us what to do, we give you a list of 1,000 things to do and you'll never get to it. And if you do that 1,000, we'll give you 1,000 more. I said, what should everyone do to get started? A small number. And to me, a number that's small was 5 to 7. And security people being what they are, they wouldn't leave the room without agreeing to 10. So a simple 2-page letter went down to some friends, the CIO of the Air Force, to the joint staff at the Pentagon, with just this kind of guidance. If you don't know what to do, start here. And that was nothing more than that. It was a very simple idea. A few months later, we got a call from the SANS Institute, who had gotten a hold of that letter and said, we like the idea. We'd like to turn it into a larger scale community project with lots of participants. I said, great, we're in. And that was that's what eventually became known as the critical security controls. It had a couple of names in between. And then a few years ago, we took the idea, spun it out into a nonprofit company, and now we're part of the Center for Internet Security. But the idea behind it was about simplicity, about foundational must-do things that allow you to do more complex things, and about making progress, not about admiring the problem. So it really was no more a grand scheme than that. Occasionally, you'll hear security professionals or vendors make a claim that the critical controls, especially the first few, are kind of too simple or too mundane. And you know, nothing could be further from the truth. Like, they really are foundational because they allow you to do lots of other things. And you know, it's like almost everything else in life, right? If you don't do the basics or the foundational things well, then it's hard to do advanced things. Some of this, I understand, is born out of frustration. It is hard to manage a large, complex, worldwide, distributed enterprise, you know, with lots of things that are constantly changing. And there's always this hope that, gee, some magic tool will appear, some brilliant new idea that we never thought of, etc., that will allow us to kind of skip all the hard work and just solve this problem with magic. Well, it hasn't happened in my 40 years in the business, and it's not going to happen in the next 40 years either, believe me. So, there's some important work to do to make sure that you can run an enterprise well, have the basics in place, and they are not trivial to do, but they are foundational so that you can be successful. And that's really the focus of those first few controls. So when people would ask me, what would be the first thing that you would try to achieve or try to do as a defender, my answer naturally became about visibility. Do Do you know what's going on in your enterprise? So visibility more specifically covers everything from what's running on my network, what devices are connected, what software is running, what control do I have over it, when are new things being installed, what human beings have the power to either bypass or change the security of my enterprise. Managing all those kinds of things is important for lots of reasons. It has security value in and of itself, but those are also the key to a well-run enterprise. So think of it kind of like public health, right? We all know we should eat better, exercise more, and it, that has benefits. But those things don't just happen by magic, right? You have to do a lot of other things to be successful there. And in fact, you get other benefits. So having discipline, right, to control what you purchase, what you bring into your life or your table or your enterprise, to know how do I get scale out of this? I want to manage my costs, right? So to do that, you have to look at this as a life cycle problem. How do I bring things in? How do I make a choice that this is a safe thing to bring in that doesn't introduce more risk than it solves? And then how do I manage it all the way through the rest of its life cycle? And we know that everything's going to change, right? From the skill of the bad guys to the flaws that are found in pieces of technology that we have in our enterprise. So you have to think of this as I'm managing a very dynamic, complicated set of variables all the time. So it's not a matter of one tool will solve this problem. It's a matter of, do I have the machinery in place to manage a complex changing problem? So that's what those early controls are about. And no one's saying that they're easy, right? They're well-defined, but that doesn't make them trivial. But also, you don't have to be perfect at them either, right? So there's lots of things you can do manually, with processes, through training of people, and then through the acquisition of technology. So these are, you know, again, there's security value there immediately. But there's also these other benefits of the discipline of running a well-run network, of scale, of cost control. You know, those kinds of things are really important. In fact, you know, enterprises have found that the better they manage that, the better their defenses will be. And you know, when the inevitable happens, right, a breach will happen someday. If you don't know what you have, it's pretty hard to recover back to some state if you haven't managed that well and have good backups and logging, and you know that you can assign accountability and all those kinds of things that you have to deal with when you have the inevitable breach.